Good afternoon, everyone. I am going to talk about the micropulse transcranial cyclophotocoagulation's role in the treatment of refractory glaucoma, our early results. As we all are aware, glaucoma is a progressive optic neuropathy. It is a leading cause of irreversible blindness, and we can treat it by medications, laser, or incisional surgery. Refractory glaucoma can be treated by transscleral cyclophotocoagulation, and it is usually used to decrease pressure in these cases. It can be done by either continuous mode or micropulse mode. Micropulse transscleral cyclophotocoagulation, that is MPTS-CPC, is a new treatment option for glaucoma. The purpose of the present study was to evaluate the early results of MPTS-CPC in refractory glaucoma. It was a prospective study of 11 patients of refractory glaucoma who underwent MPTS-CPC between March 2018 and April 2018. We included the cases of refractory glaucoma, those refractory to medical treatment as well as refractory to surgical treatment, and the cases of absolute glaucoma, that is painful blind eye. The cases with thin sclera and during treatment, the areas of staphyloma and bleb were excluded. A comprehensive ophthalmic examination was performed. All the procedures were performed under peribulbar anesthesia and in operating room. The laser used was new Cyclo G6 glaucoma laser system. The laser settings were 2000 milliwatt, 31.3% duty cycle. Laser was delivered over 360 degrees except 3 and 9 o'clock position. Here is the probe that is being shown. In each hemisphere, the probe was moved in a gradual sweeping motion for 80 seconds. The probe was put perpendicular to the globe, and there was a voice countdown timer feature on the laser. 1% atropine was instilled at the conclusion of surgery. Post-laser treatment regimen included topical steroid in tapering dose for a month. Anti-glaucoma treatment was continued, and then it was reduced gradually. The parameters studied were subjective assessment of procedural and post-laser pain. Grade 0 was no pain, grade 1 mild to moderate, and grade 2 severe pain, visual acuity, and any other complications. Follow-up was done on day 1, 1 week, 2 weeks, and 1 month. We treated 11 patients. Mean age was 56.73, males 8, 3 females. The indications were chronic angle closure glaucoma in 2 cases, post-keratoplasty glaucoma 2 cases, failed TRAP 1, silicone oil-induced glaucoma 1, neovascular glaucoma 2, and painful blind eye 3 cases. This was the intraocular pressure at various time points. So what we found was pre-laser mean pressure was 48.45, which was reduced to 24.45 at 1 month post-laser. And this was the percentage reduction in pressure at various time points. So on day one, the percentage reduction was 39.71%. And at 1 month follow-up, it was 50.51%. This was the mean percentage reduction. The mean number of anti-glaucoma medication reduced from 3.82 pre-laser to 2.45 at 1 week and 2.81 at 15 days and 1 month post-laser. Regarding procedural and post-laser pain, there were 8 patients who didn't complain of any procedural pain. 3 patients complained of mild to moderate pain. And at 1 month follow-up, there were no pain was complained by any of the patients. This was the visual acuity. Pre-laser, 4 cases had no PL, then counting finger was there in 1 case, hand movements in 3 cases, 3x60 vision, in another case, 660, and one more case had 618 vision. Regarding complications, only one patient developed bully, otherwise there were no specific complications noted. When we performed the statistical analysis by Wilcoxon signed rank test comparing IOP at different time points with pre-op IOP, the p-value was 0.003 at all time points. That is, the pressure reduction was significant. A micropulse transscleral cyclophotocoagulation has emerged as a new treatment option for glaucoma. A study by Saradi Kuchar et al. Has shown 39.1% reduction in pressure at last follow-up. No patient reported more than mild pain beyond first postoperative day. 5 patients gained one line of vision and 5 lost one line of vision. Number of medication reduced from 2.54 to 1.77, and there were no cases of prolonged inflammation or phthisis. In our study also, we got a significant pressure reduction. None of the patients reported severe procedural pain or pain at 1 month. Till 2 weeks, 2 patients reported grade 1 to 2 pain, and this was because we had 3 cases of painful blind eye in our series. Vision improved in 1 case, and none of the patients reported any deterioration. Number of medication in our study decreased from 3.82 pre-laser to 2.81 post-laser, similar to study by Saradi Kuchar et al. Then this was another study which showed mean percentage change in reduction of 30% at 1 month. And in our study also, almost similar reduction in number of medication, no major complications, but percentage change in IOP was far better in our study. Still another study by Arthur Resenda et al. Showed mean IOP reduction from 31.1 to 13.4 at 1 month. One patient had developed hypotony in this series, one patient persistent inflammation. In our cases, we didn't report these complications. In one of the studies, the number of medication decreased from 3.3 to 3 plus minus 0.3. But in our study, we had a better reduction in number of medication, that is 3.82 to 2.81, and there were no major complications similar to this study. To conclude, micropulse transscleral cyclophotocoagulation has promising outcomes. There is good evidence of IOP lowering effects of micropulse transscleral cyclophotocoagulation. There is decreased need for ocular antihypertensive medications post-procedure, and it is an effective modality of managing refractory glaucoma cases without significant side effects, as used to be seen with age-old continuous pattern cyclophotocoagulation. Thank you so much.